Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon for your Commodore Amiga personal computer system. I am Amethyst Lunatari. I just landed here on Kire's moon, Kire's moon, something like that. There's a dragon that just swooped down and destroyed our broomstick. That was awfully convenient. That's the ship we came in. We have no map now. There's no explanation for that, I don't think. If so, I forgot. get my cursor back here. I have... Hold on. How do I put this back? Hold on one second. Ah, here we go. I have a map of this called Forest Moon. This is us. We're here. So, we can't see, but there's a city or something right here. At least it seems to be. There's not much here. We got something over here, which is like a, kind of look like a ruined tower or a ruined, like, rocket buried in the ground or something like that. Other than that, we can't really see much. I mean, there's a lot of interesting, like, foliage, if you want to call it that. But I don't know if it has any significance. So as far as structures, I was only able to pick out those two. That's the whole map here. Go to the screen here. I'm recording in a window, so I'm trying to get it all in here. That's it, except for, like, little strips on either side. There's a... some kind of island here. So we've got this lake with an island in the middle. And then a river or a stream going down to here. See anything of interest at the end of the river or on the island. So I'd say head here, and then if you don't get leads on anywhere else, we head over here. Sorry if you consider it cheating, but there's no map and I don't really want to play with this like that. Oop, we went inside. Alright, so we're heading north. It's right there. So you could literally just be wandering around and not know. As you approach the solid wooden town gates, they are thrown open and a group of excited dwarves runs towards you. Your arrival is a sensation. They accompany you into the town. A crowd has gathered spontaneously on a square close to the town gates. From dozens of excited questions and answers, you draw up the following picture. As the dwarf people landed on this moon more than 20 years ago today, it quickly became clear that they were betrayed both by their customers and their own dreams. The proposed paradise full of emeralds and other precious stones proved to be a steamily humid jungle of strange plants. Wow, not full of emeralds and other precious stones. So that's why they wanted to come here. Obviously, the dwarves, they're into that thing. Into precious stones and stuff. Due to a lack of more navigation stones, the huge airship with which the dwarves arrived here could no longer be used. The first years were hard for the stranded people. The plant and animal world on the moon included some species whose characteristics excuse me, did not include hospitality and friendship. Most of the predators had developed the art of camouflage to perfection and attacked in most surprising situations. The dwarfs all suffered painful surprises and many of them fell victim, but they soon found out what animals and plants they could use as food and what others would reverse that situation. After overcoming their initial disappointment and shock, a strong camp was built which was gradually extended with numerous hardwoods to form this town. I'm just reading over this again, because when I read out loud, I'm always, you know, absorbing the information. What others would reverse that situation? What does that mean? I mean, what animals and plants could use them as food, I guess? After overcoming their initial disappointment and shock, a strong camp was built, which was gradually extended with numerous hard woods to form this town. Despite the journey being unsuccessful, Kire, the leader of the dwarfs, it bothers me, it says dwarfs instead of dwarves, insisted that both the town and the moon should be named after him. Huh. Rather egotistical of him. Many citizens of Dor Kiredon? I'm going to call it Kire because Dor Kiredon sounds more likely. Many citizens of Dor Kiredon, however, use expressions like compost heap instead of the official name Kire's moon. Compost heap. The dwarf people are said to be thick-headed, and so they initially tried to maintain their existing lifestyle in the new world. As soon as the questions of daily survival were solved, they began to explore the moon below ground level. The results were depressing. Kire's moon proved to be very poor with regard to the metals it contained, and just a few traces of iron and minerals were found, and only at great depths. Holy text dump. After approximately 10 years, something happened about which most of the dwarfs you hear speak with great reluctance. However, finally you gather that at that time, some voices were raised which were not just complaining about life on the compost heap. Many, predominantly the younger dwarfs, had become involved in more detail with the nature of the moon. They went into the forest to gather more information about the new world. Those that survived brought more knowledge and information back with them. Many of them stayed in the wilderness for longer and longer periods, and it became clear that they were becoming excited about the plants and animals on the moon. A group of these forest visitors expressed the view that one should no longer consider the nature of the moon as an enemy, but should learn to handle it in order to survive better. Such thoughts were naturally unacceptable to many older, more traditional dwarfs. Finally, some of the dwarfs moved out to establish their own town, Dor Kiredon, where they could live how they wanted. However, much you learn about the history of the dwarf people, however much you learn about the history of the dwarf people, there are always many questions you must answer about yourselves. You describe the situation at Lyramion. I was not expecting this. And the Citrine reports about some of your adventures. The dwarfs listen intently and are very disappointed that you were traveling on such a small airship and that you are now in the same situation as they, without a navigation stone for your ship, for the ship. For Kire's moon is now also your place of exile for the rest of your life. Oh, hell no, buddy. At this point in the discussion, the leader of the dwarfs, Kire himself, arrives. He also welcomes you and listens to what you have to say. But then he breaks up the meeting, and slowly the dwarfs return to their daily work, chattering in small groups. Before Kire returns to his work, he asks you to visit him as soon as possible at this house in the northwest part of the town. You take a deep breath, because we read a lot, and for the first time take a good look at the town. Oh. We're very tall. That makes sense. I mean, we could almost see on top of the largest structure here. So if we made, we don't really have a dwarf, but if we could Selena, yeah, that's more on our level, isn't it? Hey, I wanted to, like, look and speak with you. The person you are talking to is wearing heavy armor. He says, "Welcome, travelers. I am Cluckcore, the guard. It is not that I have to settle many disputes. There is also occasionally time for reflection. But danger threatens from the mad beasts around us. Sometimes they even clamber over the town walls. Oh boy. You guys are in quite a situation here. Yeah, and they're saying, intimating that we stay here for the rest of our natural lives. No. I will not accept that. Greetings. Get back here. They don't have descriptions. You speak to a guard wearing heavy armor. He says, "Welcome, airship travelers. Your landing has brought a little distraction to our sad existence. I am sorry you must pay such a high price. Exile in this horrible moon is not a happy situation." This is a sign. In elaborate lettering, the sign says, "Memories of home, the most beautiful treasures from a Lyramion castle." Where? In this building? Or displayed here? Looks like a fence? Warstone. Lower gemstone mines found. 547. I'm gonna touch it. I wanna talk to the Warstone. Okay, so this is like an outdoor museum of sorts? Firefrost, Donner's Mine, found 970. Hey, yeah, Donner's Mine. Yeah? What if we find Donner here? That'd be cool. We didn't run into him, right? Another guard over here, or is it someone we talked to? Yep. There's no need to be bashful, and I don't remember talking to him. The dwarf before you shakes his head sadly and speaks. "The airship travelers! Now you are also imprisoned on this damn moon, which we thought was paradise." I like that there's plenty of people wandering around. And I like that you can look at the item and the sign just tells you what it is. You have to figure out what sign goes to what. Mirror of the Soul. Dorba's Mine, found 339. So they brought all this stuff with them, obviously. Holds some kind of sentimental value. Firefrost. Oh, I found that. So Firefrost, that thing. And look at this one. Mountain Soul, Stein of the Forefathers. Now, a Stein is a kind of cup or something, right? Stein? And it's German. Hold on a second. I'm pretty sure it is. It's like a mug. A large mug, used especially for beer. Yeah. You know, something like that. Alright, so this is talking about this building here? Or are these the gates out? An elaborate... Oh, this is the memories. This is where I came from? And I talked to you, right? Just making sure. Yeah, you're the awesome... It looks like a Norse warrior. Stop poking him. I like their museum. I really do. Dor Kiredon. So there's a door here. Does this go out? Nope, we're in the Gemstone Inn. Sweet, named after the town Gemstone. Well, it's a little dwarf here. It's the gnome song, though. The little son of the landlord stares at you speechlessly. Apparently, he has never seen such gigantic people. Started running away from us, and we just ran him over. He's like little... Nothing special. Obviously, I'm not talking to it. Wizard says nothing special. You think it would be something we could open, right? They look like chests. As one might expect in a bar, the barrel contains beer. Just to fill those steins with. I'm surprised it says nothing special instead of just... I mean, one of them didn't respond at all. Figured they'd all be like that. Some of Doreb's possessions are stored here. Well, we don't need any of this stuff. Just in case I don't, like, anger him. Your curiosity is rewarded with a stack of rations. A stock of rations. Do we take them all? That's 110 rations. Maybe we did, because... If so, then we needed some rations. I guess we took them. What about this? Nothing special. What about this? This partially open crate here. Nothing special. Nothing special! I think I'll call this the Moon of Nothing Special. How do I get into these rooms? Like, oh, there's a way down. Look at that. It does not look like we can get there. We have to go around there through those rooms. Okay. We can do that. Oh, what's for dinner? Oh, there's a dwarf over there, full of beer. Do they make their own beer out of what they find here, or they just have beer from a huge stock they brought over? You need, like, hops, and I don't know if they have that here. Unless it's a very special beer. Hello? The wife of the landlord, well-built even for a dwarf, says, I hope you enjoy your stay with us. Hey, what do you exactly mean by well-built? Well-built. Hello? Are we behind the bar? Or is that behind? No, this is behind the bar. A bald-headed dwarf with deep lines of laughter around his eyes smiles at you. Here's Doreb. That's the stuff we found. He's an adventurer level 4 and 150 years old. That's pretty young for a dwarf, isn't it? Oh, the famous travelers. Welcome to the Gemstone Inn. Your arrival has caused great excitement. My guests will talk about this for many months. Well, that's not saying much. I'm sure they don't have much to talk about. Guess we can talk about the inn. I still remember Ambermoon, where you started off by saying hello. Now that no one knows anything about hello. Dorina suggested at that time that we should name our house after our old hometown. My wife and I try to give our guests something of the happiness of bygone times. How sad. Oh, Dorina. So Dorina is a cousin of mine and is, or better, was, Kire's wife. What happened between them was very unfortunate. It took place more than 10 years ago. Before she disappeared, she visited us very often, even if mainly to play with my newborn baby son. The whole thing is a sad loss for us all. Not just that Dorina was a wonderful person, in confidence, she was also the most gifted magician our people have produced for many, many years. You ought to talk to old Brog about her. He is now the only one of us who knows about the secret arts. A gifted magician, she was. But old Brog is now the only one who knows the secret arts. Brog is a frequent visitor here. You can meet him in the evenings. Is it the evening? What time is it? Can I ask him about Brog? You know anything special about Brog? He shows up here now. Hmm. Can I ask him about the moon? I don't know what you're talking about. Can I ask him about Kire? No. Madman, let me just try a few phrases here. Journey. What were we asking about? The nav stone? Is that what it's called? Nav stone? Or stone? Navigation stone? Does he know any magic words? Hmm. Could be Brog or whoever would know a magic word, maybe. So I gotta make sure we're here in the evening. Do you have a problem? You got a problem? I've got multiple problems. What about Schnizzum word? Trouble. The mine. Journey, did I try that? No. Alright. Farewell. I hope to be able to welcome you again here very soon. Oh, is that... Well, that's me. Well, who is standing there? Oh my gosh, this is full of beer. Okay, get a description. Nothing special. Whoops. Ah, that's a big vat of, guess what, beer? No. That contains beer, and I guess the small one contains beer as well. Mm. So there's just one thing. We're stuck on the other side of the bar. Did I talk to this one? Oh, this is the little kid. Goes out. Oh, it is the evening now. 7:30. Right. How do I get to the other side? Oh, the guy's here. I see someone. That's the wife of the lamp. But I think there's two people there. Oh, no, she changes into someone else when she sits down. Wait, we can walk in here. Okay. The bitter-looking dwarf growls, "Oh, the poor fools who have done the same as we. Welcome to the compost heap." Thank you. Beer. Oops. There's fire. Beer. Is that the one I just talked to? Yeah, right? Let me just make sure. Oh no. Oh, here's Brock. He's 310 years old and is a mystic level 8. Welcome, airship travelers. This impressive magic has been abused again to ban innocent people to eternal exile on this moon. I'm gonna ask him about magic. Still want to say hello to these people. Maybe one person will respond to hello. Magic? Oh, the magic. The fascination of secret knowledge. As you can see, I do not share the opinion held by my honored associates. Most of them think any kind of magic is not a worthy art form, and at best, they treat it with total disdain. How I long for an exchange of information with competent specialists. Well, that would be at least some of us. He begins an excited conversation with the magicians in the group. Cool. Do you know any magic words? Do you know... Are you a mage? Do you know the word schnizhimj? What's the other word? Tempest fugit, right? Do you know that word? No. What else might you know about? You know about trouble? Repairs? Problems? A problem? Hear about the mine? No. I'm surprised none of them have anything to say about Kire. He's... Seems like, you know, some of them might have differing opinions on him, but I don't have anything to say. Donner? I can't get anything out of you, can I? Anything special about yourself? We're on a moon! I wish you the very best. I think he tells me there's something more I'm supposed to talk to him about. The stocky red-nosed dwarf speaks with a heavy tongue. This unhip Unhap? Oh, damn, Moon is only tolerable when I'm in a drunken stupor. I'm guessing that's about now. What's this? I can't reach from there. What about this banner? Nothing to say, huh? There's another banner over here. It looks like a potion. So we made it to the other side. I was wondering how to get over there. Greetings. Before you stands a rotund dwarf. He is dressed in leather and cloth, and his face is sunburnt. This Dorabog. Welcome, adventurers. Even here in Dor Greston, we heard of your arrival. So I can ask him about Dor Greston. I insist on saying hello to all these people who don't know anything special about it. I sell food and come from there. It is a beautiful town, not a fortress like Dor Kiredon. Light, air, and life. You should definitely visit Dor Greston. It lies to the southwest of here, but take care, the forests are not exactly safe. Southwest. I think I know where this is. Oh, really? I mean, that's... assuming this way is north. That's northwest. So Dor Kiredon, maybe in here? Southwest. I don't see anything obvious, like a town or anything here. I don't know. I don't know where it is. Ask you anything else about Brog? About Kire? About trouble? A thing? Do you know any magic words like Tempest Fugit or Schnism? Or just say magic words in general. You don't need any of that stuff. Well, what good are you? I tell you, what good are you? About the inn? A journey? Mage. Magic. I wish they had more stuff to say about things that should matter to them. Problems. It was nice to chat. Good luck on your travels. Yeah, we didn't really talk to you about much. Alright, so we came from here. out of my way. Oh, is this an outhouse type of... That's like an area for going poops. Is that a... That looks like a way down, doesn't it? Doesn't it look like stairs down? I was certain there was like a basement. Hmm. That's why I was so determined to come over here. It's like, we can go check out the basement. No. Can't be checking out the basement. I mean, can we even stay here? I would stay here. Rent a room. What's this way? You'll be able to return to this point later. Mm-hmm. Tavern. Well, that's funny. You can go in either door, but only the fast point will be here. I mean, the quick trip, or whatever you want to call it. Fast travel. But within a city, town, whatever. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. We're going to explore the rest of Dor Kiredon next episode. Thanks for watching, and always, seek adventure.